A very good morning, friends. In our previous lecture, we already learned about the urban geography and some urban geographical models. But today's lecture is different from our regular lecture. In this today's lecture, we are going to do the study of previous year question paper of NET examination, which is conducted in 5th November 2017. So now, let us see question number first. The concept of pediplane is associated with, let us see the option. Option A, W.M. Davis, B, L.C. King, C, W. Peng, D, C.A. Cotton. And the correct answer is option B, L.C. King. Let us see the other option also. Option A, W.M. Davis is an American geomorphologist who postulated his concept of geographical cycle and popularly known as cycle of erosion. Option C, W. Peng is noted for criticizing key element of the division cycle of erosion. He postulated his theory on landscape development. And D, C.A. Cotton, he is an New Zealand geomorphologist. His theory on savanna planation. So, B option is correct. L.C. King is an geologist who postulated his concept of pediplane is also known as pediplanation. Question number second. The direction of horizontal line on the inclined rock strata is known as. Let us see the options. A, anticline, B, deep, C, syncline, and D, strike. And the correct answer is D, strike. The strike of the inclined beds is the direction of any horizontal line along the bedding plane, and the direction of dip of rock beds is always at right angle to the strike. Let us see the other option also. Option A, anticline. The upfolded rock beds are called anticline. Option B, dip. The inclination of rock beds with respect to the horizontal plane is called dip. And C, syncline. The downfolded rock beds due to compressive force is called syncline. Question number third. Who started that the slope profile are convex plane or concave according to the circumstance of the uplifting action? Let us see the option. Option A, Peng, B, Davis, C, Johnson, and D, Wood. And the correct answer is Pink. His statement of the slope profiles are convex plane or concave. Question number four. The premise that the present day process have been operate throughout geological time is the principle of. Let us see the option. Option A, isostasy, B, dystropism, C, uniformitarianism, and D, catastrophism. And the correct answer is uniformitarianism. Uniformitarianism is a school of thought based on the view that processes currently acting upon the earth are virtually the same as those have been acting through geological time. This idea was first outlined by Houghton in late 18th century and developed by C. Lyell in the early 19th century. Let us see the other option also. First, isostasy. It is indicate the state of balance which he thought must exist between large upstanding area of the earth's surface. Next, B, dystropism. It is also called tectonism, large-scale deformation of earth crust by natural process which leads to the formation of continents and ocean basin by mechanism such as lithospheric plate. And last, catastrophism. This theory propounded by George Cuvier. Catastrophism is a theory that the earth has largely been shaped by sudden, short-lived, violent event, possible worldwide in scope. Question number 5. Match the list first with the list second and select the correct answer from the code given below. In the list first, they given a scholar, and in the list second, they given a theory. So let us see. In the list first and second, first one, Hall and Dana, who propounded a theory of geosyncline, then Horton, who propounded a theory of uniformitarianism, then Harry Hayes, who propounded a theory of seafloor spreading, and last one, Jeffrey, who propounded a theory of thermal convection. So our correct answer is option D. Question number 6. Given below are two statements, one labeled as assertion and the other labeled as reason. Select your correct answer from the code given below. So please read carefully both the options. First one is assertion and next one is reason. So let us see. First one, assertions. There is closed relationship between volcanic activity and plate margins. And reason, a vast majority of world's volcanoes are associated with the convergent plate margins. And let us see the options. Both A and R are true, and R is correct explanation of A. B, both A and R are true, but R is not correct explanation of A. And C, A is true, but R is false. And last one, A is false, but R is true. And our correct answer is A. Both A and R are true, and R is correct explanation of A. Because convergent plate boundaries are located where lithospheric plate are moving towards one another. And thus, the earthquake volcanic activities and crustal distortions happen here. Question number 7. Match the list first with the list second and select the correct answer from the code given below. In the list first, they given a topography, and in the list second, they given a landforms. So let us see the topography and landforms. So glacial landforms, so arid, it is a glacial landforms. Then Tombolo, it is a marine landforms. Then Alluvial Fan, it is a fluvial landforms. And last one, Yardang, it is a Aeolian landforms. So our correct answer is option D. Question number 8. Match the list first with the list second and select the correct answer from the code given below. In the list first, they given an author, and in the list second, they given a book. So let us see. In the list first and list second, J.A. Strauss, who write a book on unstable earth, then S.W. Ulrich, who write a book on spirit and purpose of geography, then Walter Penck, who write a book on morphological analysis, and last one, Thorne Bure, who write a book on principle of geomorphology. So our correct answer is option D. Question number 9. Which one of the following is the correct average slope of the typical front in weather phenomenon? And the correct answer is option B. The slope of a typical cold front is 1 as to 100 vertical to horizontal. Question number 10. Match the list first with the list second and select the correct answer from the code given below. In the list first, they given a conference report, and in the list second, they given a conference held in or paper published in. So let us see the list first and second. First, global climate change impact the United States. This paper published in 2009. Then Stockholm conference held in 1972. Then third, fourth assessment report of the IPCC. It is published in 1992. And last one, Rio conference held in 2007. So our correct answer is option D. Question number 11. In which of the following atmospheric layer temperature remain constant? Option A, troposphere, B, tropopause, C, mesosphere, and D, troposphere. And the correct answer is option B, tropopause, because tropopause is a boundary between troposphere and stratosphere. It's a thin layer where the temperature remains constant, while in other layer temperature change according to their height. For example, troposphere, it is the lowermost layer of the atmosphere, and almost all of the weather phenomenon occur in this layer, like cloud, fog, rainfall, hailstorm. So in this layer, temperature decreases with increasing height at the rate of 6.5 degrees Celsius per 1000 meter. Next, stratosphere. It is a layer just above the troposphere. In this layer, heat is produced in the process of formation of ozone, and this heat is responsible for temperature increasing. Next one, mesosphere. It is extended between 50 to 80 km. In this layer, temperature again decreases with increasing height at the uppermost limit of mesosphere. Temperature becomes 80 degrees Celsius. This limit is called mesopause. And last and uppermost layer, which is not given in this option, that is thermosphere, where the temperature increasing rapidly with increasing height. Question number 12. Which of the following is the correct wind from the equator to the pole? So our correct answer is option D, trade winds, subtropical high, westerly, and polar easterly. Question number 13. Given below are two statements, one labeled as assertion and the other labeled as reason. Select your answer from the code given below. Let us see the assertion. Above 1000 meter altitude, most winds flow a geostropic or near geostropic course. And the reason is the friction layer of the atmosphere extend to only about 1000 meters above the grounds. So assertion is correct and the reason also correct. So our correct answer is option A. Both A and R are true, and R is the correct explanation of A. Question number 14. Which of the following isotherm for the average temperature of the warmest month is generally accepted as? Option A, 2 degrees Celsius, B, 10 degrees Celsius, C, 5 degrees Celsius, and D, 15 degrees Celsius. So the correct answer is option B, 10 degrees Celsius. Question number 15. Given below are two statements, one labeled as assertion and the other labeled as reason. Select your answer from the code given below. So please read carefully both two options, assertion and reason. Okay, so let us see first one, assertion. The trade wind is predominantly easterly, and their reason is an easterly wind blow from west to east. So the reason is wrong, because easterly wind is blow from east to west, and that's why it is called as easterly wind. So the reason is wrong. So our correct answer is option C. A is true, but R is false. Question number 16. Which one of the following type of climate is appropriate for BWh in Köppen's World Climate Classification? Let us see the options. ऑप्शन ए सबट्रॉपिकल डेजर्ट क्लाइमेट, ऑप्शन बी सबट्रॉपिकल स्टेपी क्लाइमेट, सी मिड लैटिट्यूड डेजर्ट क्लाइमेट एंड डी मिड लैटिट्यूड स्टेपी क्लाइमेट एंड हेयर ऑप्शन ए इज करेक्ट. इन कोपेन्स वर्ल्ड क्लाइमेटिक क्लासिफिकेशन अंडर हेडिंग 13 द सब डिविजन BWA स्टैंड्स फॉर सबट्रॉपिकल डेजर्ट क्लाइमेट, सो ए इज करेक्ट ऑप्शन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 17, विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग वैल्यू ऑफ टेम्परेचर इज करेक्ट फॉर द एवरेज फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट फॉर सी वॉटर इन आर्टिक एंड अंटार्कटिक सीज. लेट अस सी द ऑप्शन. ऑप्शन ए 2 डिग्री सेल्सियस, बी 0 डिग्री सेल्सियस, सी -2 डिग्री सेल्सियस एंड लास्ट वन डी -10 डिग्री सेल्सियस. एंड द करेक्ट आंसर इज -2 डिग्री सेल्सियस. टेम्परेचर द सी वॉटर ऑफ आर्टिक एंड अंटार्कटिक सी इज फ्रीज्ड. क्वेश्चन नंबर 18, मैच द लिस्ट फर्स्ट विद द लिस्ट सेकंड एंड सिलेक्ट द करेक्ट आंसर फ्रॉम द कोड गिवन बिलो. इन द लिस्ट फर्स्ट दे गिवन अ प्लेट नेम एंड इन द लिस्ट सेकंड दे गिवन अ डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्लेट मोमेंट. राइट, सो लेट अस सी द लिस्ट फर्स्ट एंड लिस्ट सेकंड. Indo Australian plate, it moved towards north. Then Caucasus plate moved towards the northwest. Then Pacific plate, it moved towards the west. And last one, Nazca plate, it moved towards the east. So our correct answer is option B. Question number 19, which one of the following period when the sea level around the world was as much as 130 meter lower than today. Let us see the option. Holocene, Pleistocene, Miocene and D Cambrian. So our correct answer is option B, Pleistocene. At about 21,000 year ago, during the last glacial sea level was about 130 meter lower than today. So that's why our correct answer is option B. Question number 20. Given below are two statements, one labeled as assertion and the other labeled as reason. Select your answer from the code given below. Let us see the assertion. The moon produces greater percentage of Earth's tide than the sun. And the reason is the sun closer to the Earth than the moon. So here assertion is correct, but reason is wrong. So our correct answer is option C. A is true, but R is false. If you see in the diagram, the moon is closer to the Earth than the sun. And due to the nearness, moon produces greater percentage of Earth's tide than the sun. Thank you, friends. If this video helped you in your study, please do like. If you not already subscribed, then do subscribe. If you didn't like the content, give a thumbs down. Okay, see you with next lecture.